and come away stronger. So she left the city behind. Before her lay a great mine. Idle winds played in her hair. She smiled for a moment, delighting in its feather touch, until the wind picked up, and tornado's fury blotted out the sun. She saw islands floating in the sky ahead of her, as if the tornado had ripped the very earth asunder. Windmills rotated lazily in the distance. A deceptive calm filled the air. Magnolia winds swept gently through her hair. The land lay broken around her, fractured by the tornado's blow. She wondered if she were broken too. She wondered what stories had been unearthed. By the tornado's furious passage, who will tell my story? What is my story? A latticework of ruins surrounded her. Arches of bone and columns of ivory. A skeleton home. A confusion of wind swept past her. A 100 dissenting voices. The soft zephyr carried poisonous lies. The ragged Soraka whispered sweet nothings. The cacophony threatened to blow her away. Until all fell still. The winds settled in her palm, like a butterfly. And her voice carried the will of a hurricane. The winds began to give her direction. They carried her. She wondered whether that would be enough. It was something, at least. Wind picked up from nowhere. Death Rider. Storm's strength was fading. Oh. landscape had surrendered to the winds. Islands scattered, pieces of her. Was she really here?
Thank you.
Really here? She found the center of the islands, the eye of the storm. She left the islands with renewed purpose. She realized that she felt whole for the first time.